You've been in an accident. You've been seriously injured. You have permanent injuries. How does your attorney prove those economic losses at trial? The subject of today's video is about the use of an economist. I'm Dave Gladhorn. I'm an attorney in West Palm Beach. I exclusively represent injured people. In many cases, we need to bring an economist in because what the economist does is he will take the raw data, the loss of wages, the fact that someone used to be able to earn $15 an hour, now they can only earn $5 an hour. The fact that they're going to need continuous medical care for the rest of their life. And what he does is he crunches those numbers down to come to a figure that if you give the injured person this sum at the end of the trial, because remember, the injured person only has one day in court. If you give the injured person this sum at the end of the trial, that'll compensate them for these economic losses, not the human losses, but the economic losses. This is a chart from a case that we did a little while ago, and it breaks down and shows you what the economist does. He has two periods here, the period up to the trial and then the period after the trial, the future loss and the past loss. And you can see here that past value of replacement labor was $28,000. The past value of lost services, because he could no longer do the work around the house that he used to be able to, and his wife had to hire people to do that work, was $13,000. Past medical expenses at that time were $96,000. So just in the past, he had incurred expenses, losses, economic losses, of $137,466. Now, the economist takes out his crystal ball, and he crunches the numbers as far as what is this person going to need in the future. And what he's done is a very conservative calculation, because he only took the individual up to the age 70, whereas most people really live longer than that. But just to be conservative and to be fair on all sides, and present value of the cost of labor in the future is lost in labor in the future, $203,185. Present value of future medical expenses, that is to compensate him for what he's going to incur in the future, $307,389,000. If you add up both the past and the future, you come to a total of $648,040. That might sound like a lot of money, right, if you just hear it in one sum, but it's basically scientific calculation that leads to that number. And it is only a fair way to compensate someone that only has one day in court. Why am I telling you all this? Because you have questions. You have concerns. Call me. We can answer your questions. We can address your concerns. I'm Dave Gladhorn. I thank you for watching this video.